One of my most anticipated movies, which was Terry Gilliam's latest film, The Man Who Killed Don Quixote.
Ooh, I had tickets to this, and then we got a snowstorm in Minnesota, and I was like, I'm not going to go outside in my little Honda Civic and probably die for The Man Who Killed Don Quixote.
It's back in theaters, so you can still see
it. Is it actually?
Yeah. Like, we have it, like, this week is, like, actual shows. I'll cut that out of the podcast, but you can see it.
Okay. That's actually awesome. I'm going to see it then.
Okay, cool.
Thank you for telling me that. Thank you.
It's very
genuine. Ethan, genuinely, thank you for that bit of knowledge.
You're welcome.
Okay, that scared the fucking life out of me. Did you also see the curse of La... I don't know how to say it.
Oh, come on. Give it to me.
The curse of La... Word. Laronia. I don't know how to do it, dude.
Laronia? La Llorona?
I would like the people to know that I took 4 years of Spanish in high school. It took me
apparently 4 years of Spanish 1.
Okay, well, here we go. It took me 3 years to get past Spanish 1, and then I go in senior year for Spanish 2. They're like, I hope you remember everything from Spanish 1. I was like, I remember nothing. Dropped it the next week. So, but how did you like this movie?
It was fine.
Oh, wow. Okay, so my life was not worth going to this movie.
No, it's one that Terry Gilliam has been trying to make for quite a while. I think it's like 25 plus years at this point, riddled with conflict and flooding and actors getting sick and like legal battles and like all the fun stuff that, you know, Terry Gilliam has to do anytime he tries to make anything, which is great. I think he is literally cursed. So I'm happy that it's just out and he's done with it. Wow. Like, can move on with his life now.
Yeah.
Jonathan Pryce is at the top of his game. Adam Driver is at the top of his game.
I would say
Terry Gilliam is not as much at the top of his game, which is weird. So it's closer to something like Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas than it would be something like Brazil.
Okay.
The way that Gilliam moves the camera, I think in this movie specifically, it kind of takes away from like the gorgeous set design and like costume work that people like actually put a lot of time and effort into. Mainly because of how things interact with. So if you take a look at Brazil, my favorite movie of all time, Gang, the way that the set design works in that is a lot of the things are in the background and supposed to be like ignored. So like, it's okay when the camera doesn't focus on them, but in this world, it doesn't really have as good of effect. That's kind of hard to, I don't think I worded that the best way I could have, but anyway.
I already know what you're saying, to be honest.
It's a really fun movie.
It's a good film that you don't think compares to his other works.
Exactly. Okay. It's good. It's not great. It's definitely not great. But it's enjoyable. Hands down, Adam Driver, Jonathan Pryce, if they did not deliver the performance they did, movie would be nothing. They are both fantastic in this. Big ups to Jonathan Pryce. And that wraps up that review. If you want to hear more reviews and other snippets from our full monthly show, go ahead and click the box over here. Or you can also check out our weekly mini episodes in the other box.
Yeah, and make sure to hit the circle in the middle to subscribe.